South Korea is one of the fastest growing economies in the world, and there's a core focus on overseas alternative investments in order to protect and diversify their portfolios. We think it's a great opportunity for them to find responsible and very astute asset managers to diversify their investments.
Korea is a very important market for us as we continue to expand globally. We have a vision of really being able to deliver fintech solutions on a global basis, really starting with Southeast Asia. And Korea is one of those key markets that we know it's important to make our mark on in order to continue to expand globally.
Korea has always been an innovative country which is open to new opportunities, and its business culture is also pretty ready to accept new innovations, specifically in this industry. That is why it's very important for us to be here and present our product.
Korea is important for IFC for a couple of reasons. Number one, Korea is a big stakeholder in the World Bank Group, which we're part of. Number two, we have a commitment to Korea. We have an office here in Korea. And number three, we have institutional investors here in Korea that we've partnered with. So for those reasons, Korea is very important to us.
Thank you, appreciate it.
Well, to the UK, the Koreans are really important for a couple of reasons. They're big investors, and they're long-term investors as well. They're a big percentage of the market in terms of investment in property. They're very supportive of infrastructure funds in the UK. And they're also actually quite interested in some of the cutting-edge technologies around fintech.
Korean LPs, basically, and related industries, very active in alternative investments, and also they look at Europe, also they look at emerging Europe, and also the product, our product, non-performing loans and distressed assets is quite known to Korean investors, so that's the main reason.
Thank you, appreciate it.
So I am the CIO of Skybound Capital, which is a global asset manager. And the majority of our clients at the moment are from Europe. But in the most recent years, we have seen tremendous growth from Asia, particularly Northeastern Asia. We have continuously talked to a lot of Korean retail as well as Korean institutional investor for many years. We never managed to really see significant inflow, to be frank, from the market, but I think that is probably the same experience with many other alternative managers as well. But things are changing very fast now, and we do believe, particularly for Korean institutional investors, it is about time to increase, if not starting to have alternative allocation. And we have seen very positive signs from institutional investors here. We always believe this is going to be a very big market for alternative investment simply because of the wealth accumulated here.
So the Korean market is unique in the sense that it is a, in my opinion, a very aggressive early adopter market. And you can see that across multiple investment categories as well as technology. And because, as you well know, venture capital is in the intersection of technology and investments, Korea is a very important market. Our firm, Translink, we work very closely with some of the leading technology companies in Korea, the big telcos, consumer electronics, internet, mobile gaming, auto companies. And because of that, I visit Korea on a regular basis every couple months to meet with the corporate partners that we work with and also introduce some of the innovative tech companies. About 3 years ago, we also started a local fund in Korea, where we are also invested in local Korean startups.
Okay, all right.
네, 한국에 지금 많은 블록체인 프로젝트들이 나오고 있고 실제로 실생활에 쓰이기 위해서 이제 프로덕트를 딜리버리를 하고 있는데 한국 마켓 같은 경우는 일단 많은 사람들이 블록체인에 대해서 블록체인에 대한 이해도가 다른 국가보다 높은 편이고 크립토커런시를 많이 보유하고 있기 때문에 아무래도 프로덕트가 나왔을 때 이제 좀 더 마켓 페네트레이션이 빨라질 것으로 예상하고 있고 그런 관점에서는 블록체인이라는 새로운 기술이 나왔을 때 좋은 테스트 베드가 될 수 있을 것 같습니다.